Good morning, everyone. How are we doing this morning, family? We're good? We're gonna have a fantastic show. Yesterday we had a great day of jazz down here for the Midwest Clinic, and today we're gonna have another one. My name is Jose Antonio Diaz. I'm on the board director here for the Midwest Clinic. Myself with Dick Dunscombe and Tony Garcia, I'm excited to welcome you for another great day of jazz. So, are you ready to hear some fantastic music?
I heard this group during sound check, and you're in for a great time. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce this amazing group. This is the Cedar Falls High School Jazz 1 under the direction of Kyle Engelhardt.
Terry White, Thank you so much for coming to see us this morning. We're really excited to play, and we're going to keep going here. I get to do something really fun and introduce one of my great friends. Teaches jazz at the University of Northern Iowa, which is in our hometown. And not only is Chris Merz an incredible saxophonist, but he's an incredible educator and has a beautiful heart. So would you please welcome to the stage Mr. Chris Merz. Thank you. one of the things that the Midwest Clinic asked us to do as we were preparing our big band programs to also consider the history of where big bands came from, and that was out of the combo idiom. And one of the neatest things that's come out recently has been Jennifer Wharton and her professional trombone quartet. And we heard them, we being me and Kristen, 2 years ago in Des Moines at Noche, and Kristen got to meet Jennifer, and Jennifer's just the sweetest person in the world. And she talked about this next tune, and it's North Rampart by Alan Ferber. And it was originally written for big band, and when Jennifer was in that big band, she wanted to play it, and it made her inspired to improvise. And so she asked her friend Alan to rearrange it for trombone quartet, and it's this beautiful, gorgeous arrangement that just came out. It's a reverent portrayal of New Orleans after Katrina, and it's going to feature three seniors and a junior. The junior's the short one. And this is Alan Ferber's North Rampart for Jennifer Wharton.
Thank you.
while we're getting everybody back on stage. I had a cool story about this next chart. It was composed for one of our junior highs back in 2018. And Eric Lentz, one of our band directors at Cedar Falls, teaches a really great seventh grade jazz band and starts amazing rhythm sections and amazing players every year. And he was looking for more good junior high literature. Those of you that teach junior high jazz or look for grade one or two jazz, you understand completely, right? So he passed the hat at a band concert. Said, hey, we're gonna pass the hat, we're gonna get a commission. And the Pete band parents chipped in and got a commission. And we got Calypso, Angelical written in 2018. And it's super cool because it's written by one of our very good friends who's here in the audience, Mr. Steve Shanley. Steve? Steve teaches just about an hour away from us at Coe College, and it's published by Oskaloosa Barnhouse Company, CL Barnhouse, which is also an Iowa tie. So we've got our Cedar Falls Junior High, our friend Steve writing a great chart, and our Iowa publishing company. So we're really, really excited to play this for you. Some of the kids that premiered this in 2018 when it was a manuscript are in the band right now, playing it at New West, which is pretty darn cool. So this is Steve's Calypso Angelical. Thank you. know the fun thing about being here is looking out in the audience and seeing so many friends and colleagues. It's wonderful to be on this stage. Thank you for coming and sharing it with us. Sharing the next tune with us is Marques Carroll, a native Chicago trumpet player. He's sponsored and co-part by Bach Brass. And Marques is the real deal, you guys. Like, he came in for rehearsal yesterday, he talked to the kids, he helped us rehearse a little bit. And then we went to Andy's last night, and Marques was leading the jam session and gave us a little shout out, which was super cool. But Marques's heart is as big as his sound. And please help me give a warm welcome to Marques Carroll. Chris will be back for our last selection, so don't go anywhere yet. There's a ton of joy there in that Duke Ellington writing. And the piece that we're going to be playing next, First In, Last Out, also has a ton of joy. And I'm so excited to get to play it here for you all. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you find it meaningful and consider playing it with your own students. One of my very best friends, Joe Turner, I went to college, and we've known each other for 25 years. and in 2015 he was diagnosed with lymphoma, and in 2018 he passed away. But before he died, we were, several of our friends here, were in his hospital at this room, and he said, "You guys, there's one thing I really want to get done that I didn't get to do." And he was the amazing band director. He took his band to essentially Ellington, won all kinds of festivals, but beyond that, he was an amazing teacher, just one of the absolute best, and taught at West Point Ballet. And his student, Brett Neal, who played in that essentially Ellington band, was tragically killed in a car accident. And so Joe asked us in the hospital room, he said, "Hey, would you please get a commission done in honor of Brett?" Brett was an amazing drummer. He was always the first in and the last out at rehearsal. He always took care of the band, he always took care of the kids, he always took care of setting up equipment and doing everything. And we said, "Yes, Joe, we got you. We'll get that done." And Joe died in April, and less than 6 months later, we had a chart written by Bob Washut, who's one of our very good friends, teaches at the University of Northern Iowa, Professor Emeritus of Jazz there. And this piece is everything that Joe wanted. He wanted something that people could improvise on, that brought joy, and that wasn't somber. He wanted it to feature drums, but not be a drum feature. And Bob nailed it. It's a great chart, and we're so excited to perform first in, last out for you. We have one last tune, and I have some thank yous. There's so many people to make this happen, but thank you to President Rodney Dorsey and the Midwest Clinic Board of Directors, Jazz Liaison Jose Diaz, and Kelly Bell, Executive Director. Thank you to our sponsors who helped with this trip and gave us an amazing experience and provided a lifetime of memorable moments for these students. Our two incredible guests are Marques Carroll and Chris Merz. They're great musicians, they're great educators. You can be both, it's okay. I'd like to have our wonderful Cedar Falls instrumental music staff stand and be recognized. They're all here today: Joe Amsberry, Nikki Davis, Eric Linz, Ben Byersdorfer, Laura Engelhardt, and Gerald Ramsey. They're all here today. They're the reason I get to have this much fun. Thank you to the parents of these wonderful students who've traveled to come see them play today and have supported them and me on this incredible journey. They're wonderful, wonderful parents. Students, thank you for the hard work, the laughter, the willingness to take chances. We had 15 kids solo today, all of them improvised. I'm so proud of that, that you're doing that. High school band director, I told him I wanted to be a music major. He said, "You got to go to Midwest with me." I said, "Oh, okay, what's that?" We came, and on the way home, he said, "What'd you think?" I said, "Oh man, wouldn't it be cool to bring band there someday?" And he said, "Well, yeah, good luck." he said, "You have to work really hard, but it's okay. Take a chance, dream big." And so, Dad, Mom, thank you. Without their love and support and me ignoring them for the last 6 months, we'd still be in Cedar Falls, so thank you very much. We've got one more for you. We're going to have a lot of fun. This is Stephen Feifke's I've Got Algorithm, and please welcome back to the stage Mr. Chris Merz and Mr. Marques Carroll.
Yeah, you should have.